Hi, Central Bible Church family. It was really great to see so many of you at our worship on the lawn this last Sunday evening. And I was just reminded once again how important it is for the people of God to be together. It was such a great evening. And it gave me great excitement knowing that we're going to be able to come together soon. Now, before I tell you about those plans, I want to answer the question that I've heard so many people ask. Why has it taken us so long to come together? And the answer is because we just want to be safe. We want to do what's best for the greatest number of people and do our part as a church in loving our neighbors and not spreading the COVID-19 virus. You see, churches present a rather unique opportunity for the virus. The virus is spread through touching one another, and of course, when we come to church, that's what we want to do. The virus is spread through actually singing or yelling, and of course, when we come together to worship, that's what happens. The virus is spread through people being in close proximity in closed spaces. And so churches, unlike Walmart or Kroger or any other place, really presents a unique opportunity. And we have wanted to wait until we believed we could see the numbers going down and we knew that it was okay for us to come together. And we believe that we've reached that place. And so our plan here at Central Bible Church is to come back together for on-campus worship on June 21st, okay? That's two Sundays from now. And we're excited to regather in kind of corporate worship, and we're looking forward to being back together. Now, that doesn't mean that everyone should show up on June 21st. And I wanted to come to you today in person to just kind of give you a picture of what it's going to look like and some kind of protocols we've put into place and to give you a picture of what is probably going to be a new normal for us for just in the short term. Let me say, first of all, that if you are someone that is part of the at-risk population, you have an underlying health condition, you're sick, you're one of our more mature saints that goes to our church, I'm going to continue to urge you to stay at home. We don't want you to come back because of the potential risk that it could cause to you. We will continue to offer our live stream worship services probably until Jesus returns. It's been so successful that we will continue to make sure that you have the ability to participate in our worship services from your home every single Sunday. Now, for those of you that are wondering about whether or not you should return on Sunday, June 21st, let me tell you about how we're going to do this. First of all, at least for the first week or two, it's going to be by reservation only. And I know that sounds ridiculous. The notion that God's people would actually have to make a reservation to come to church, it just feels so weird to me. But let me tell you why we're doing that. We need to know how many people will show up for the 9 o'clock worship service that we have on Sunday morning so that if we get a significant number of people, significant number of reservations, we will know to open up a second worship service. When you come on Sunday morning, for those of you that have made reservations, it's going to be a little bit of a different experience. And again, I'm hoping that this will just be short term, but let me tell you about that experience. First of all, again, if you're an at-risk, part of the at-risk population, I'm going to really urge you in love to stay at home. If you decide to come on Sunday morning and you've made your reservation, we're going to ask you to come into the worship center between about 8:40 and 9:05. That means that if you arrive at 8:30, we don't want you to come and stand in the lobby. We don't want you to have conversations with one another. We'd really prefer for you to just stay in your car and wait until 8:40, 8:45, come into the main building and come immediately into the worship center. Now, let me tell you, for some of you that have the spiritual gift of lateness, you're going to have to work on this because at 9:05, depending on how many people we have in our worship center, you may not be permitted to come in after 9:05. We may be at capacity and unable to seat you. So please be sure that you're at Central Bible Church on time for that Sunday morning. When you come into the worship center, we're also going to urge you not to touch one another. And that goes back to the sermon that I preached a couple of weeks ago. Because none of us know if we're carriers of COVID-19, the best way that we're going to love one another is by not touching one another. And I know as Christians, that feels so, it feels so counter to our experience as those who love one another. But we're going to ask you not to do high fives, not to hug, not to do handshakes. We're going to have to come up with some cool new way that we here at Central Bible Church express our love to one another. But we're really going to discourage you from touching among non-family members. Also, when you come into the worship center, you're going to notice that every other row is going to be blocked off. You're not going to be able to sit in every single row. And that is in order to help us maintain good social distance from one another. In fact, anytime you're on campus, whether you're in the restroom or up in the lobby or in the worship center, we're really going to urge you to maintain that 6 feet of social distance, which I know is it's so hard. But the more that we can do that, the better that we can protect one another. And then the other precaution that we're going to take is we're all going to wear face coverings. And I know that that statement right there probably caused some of you to say, well, then I'm not showing up for church. And that might be possible, that you may feel uncomfortable wearing a face covering and say, I don't want to do that. But if you say, I'm coming to church on Sunday morning, you're going to have to wear a face covering. I'm going to be wearing one. All of our staff are going to be wearing, our elders are going to be wearing a face covering. And the reason is because during singing, medical professionals have said there is a greater exposure both in those that are potentially projecting the virus, and also among those who are breathing more deeply during singing for them to catch the virus. And so while we are singing, while we're in the building and we're singing, we're all going to wear face coverings together. Now, during the sermon time, you're welcome to pull your mask down. You can take a breath. You don't have to wear it the whole time. But anytime we have corporate worship, we're going to be wearing our face coverings together. When I'm preaching from the platform or our worship leaders are leading, they won't be wearing face coverings because they will be far enough away from the whole congregation. And as well, your elementary school children don't have to wear face coverings. This is really junior high, senior high, and our adult population. We're urging to wear the face coverings. And so these are some of the precautions that we're going to take when we come back together. Now, I want to let you know that on June 21st, we're not yet ready for our children's ministry, our student ministry, and our community group Sunday Bible studies coming together. We're still going to hold those ministries kind of remotely, whether it's by Zoom. I know a lot of you have been meeting on Zoom conferences together. Our student ministries have been having some opportunities off campus. We're holding off on those ministries until we're sure that we have all of the volunteers that we need for those ministries and that we feel like the appropriate precautions have been put into place so that we can regather those individual ministries. God willing, we'll be able to do that sometime in July. So pray for us in that way. And then finally, let me just reiterate, we will continue our online presence. This is also true for families that have children. You know that this last Sunday, we started a great online video teaching session so that while when I get up to deliver my sermon, parents can kind of plug and play an age-appropriate message for their preschool or their elementary school kids. We're going to continue doing that so that you as parents that are not yet ready to return will be able to follow the whole service online, and then for your children, you'll be able to plug and play what we have prepared for them. Listen, church, these are weird times, and I never would have imagined in my lifetime that the Church of Jesus Christ would have faced what we're facing. But God has done a remarkable work, not only in the churches around the world. I think He's done something really remarkable in Central Bible Church. There is a strong sense of unity, a strong sense of generosity, a strong sense of community. God has sustained us these days. And though I think it's going to take us a while, step by step, week by week, for all of us to kind of come back together, I think that the Lord is in that and that He is going to bring us back together as strong as we were before we hit COVID-19. Two things you can do. Continue to have patience. Thank you. You've been amazing as a church. And continue to remain in prayer. Pray for me and the rest of our team as leaders. Pray for our church. Pray for churches everywhere that God will continue to make Himself known through His people. So thanks for taking time to listen to this. I'm encouraged, and be sure that you click on the link in this email to reserve your spot on June 21st. I'll look forward to seeing you whether we're live or live stream. God bless you.